I think this is also the next stage of our investment in Indonesia. We want to invest in our people, in our team. We want to hire the best talents so that we can actually bring to the next level.
But now we see the Indonesian market, the customers here really forward looking, are really planning for the future, really wanting to make sure that they have a good foundation.
Pointstar Indonesia baru saja meresmikan workspace terbarunya di Sampurna Strategic Square, Jakarta Selatan. Tepatnya berlokasi di South Tower lantai 16. Pelopor penyedia solusi cloud dan konsultasi IT di Asia Tenggara ini menyadari dengan penambahan kapasitas dan fasilitas lewat ruang kerja baru ini, sumber daya manusia yang ada dalam perusahaan dapat berkembang dengan lebih baik lagi. CEO Pointstar Justin Lee menegaskan bahwa lewat sumber daya manusia, sekaligus fasilitas yang memadai, pekerjaan dapat diselesaikan dengan lebih efektif untuk kenyamanan para rekan kerja dan pelanggan Pointstar. Baginya, kantor baru ini adalah salah satu bentuk investasi Pointstar untuk mencapai kinerja maksimal.
In Indonesia, we are doing a lot of consulting work. We are building solutions, we're building technology, cloud and ERP and AI solutions for our customers. So we need to hire the best people in Indonesia. So we are actually investing in an office that allows them to do their best work. So we want to create a workspace which is built for modern times, right? So we can have what we call a hybrid workspace. We build a lot of video conferencing. So our employees actually can come to office to work. They can collaborate better. But we've also designed it so that they can actually also work from home. Or they can work remotely sometimes, right? So that actually allows them to collaborate. So we can work with our team in other countries like Singapore, in Kuala Lumpur, right? We can also work with our other team in Bandung, and they can work efficiently to deliver good projects to customers.
Menilik capaian pertumbuhan Pointstar pada 2023 dan menargetkan perkembangan di tahun ini, CEO dari Pointstar Consulting, Michelle Alfonso, juga berpendapat senada dengan Justin. Menyambut prospek bisnis di Indonesia pada 2024, Michelle percaya bahwa investasi internal pada kualitas sumber daya manusia di Pointstar haruslah diutamakan, mulai dari menunjang kenyamanan bekerja, pemberian training bagi para karyawan, menerapkan pola kerja lewat pemberian konsultasi hulu ke hilir yang komprehensif, serta pelayanan yang berorientasi pada solusi. Dengan ini, Pointstar optimistis dapat menyediakan pelayanan terbaik lewat pemberian solusi yang adaptif dan tepat sasaran.
Indonesia being such a big country, right, there are still certain industries, right, that have not maybe fully adopted, you know, to the full potential of what they can do from a digital perspective, right? And there are many solutions out there, the many best of breed solutions that Pointstar actually works very hard to, you know, make sure that our team is trained on. And so we actually not just doing the implementation, but we also do a consultation with our customers to understand their needs, putting the customer first, right, in terms of recommending what solutions would work for them, and you know, in terms of bringing them through the whole journey of implementation as well as ongoing support, right? So I think that we hope that Pointstar can actually play that role for the companies in Indonesia, right, who are also aligning with the government's initiative to go digital.
Dalam momen grand opening ceremony wajah baru kantor Pointstar dan Pointstar Consulting, turut diadakan sejumlah selebrasi. Ada penampilan barongsai dan tradisi Yusheng yang unik karena berbentuk mengular dengan kepala berbentuk naga, sebagai simbol keberuntungan dan kesuksesan yang tak putus-putus di kantor baru Pointstar ini. Harapannya, Pointstar dapat terus menjadi perusahaan penyedia solusi cloud dan konsultasi IT yang dapat terus diandalkan di seluruh Asia Tenggara.